Hello everyone. So in the last class we have discussed the various methods of gear generations, gear manufacturing, which basically use the two techniques. First one is the gear generation process and the second one is the gear forming process. In the case of gear generation process, we have discussed the Sutherland rack arrangement, gear shaping process and the gear hobbing process. So this is the gear shaping process, which involves a cutter, and this cutter rotates and reciprocates and cuts the desired teeth on the gear blank. And this one is the gear hobbing process, in which a hob is used which rotates and cuts the teeth on the gear blank. Now for the better understanding of these two gear generation process, let us see a small video. So in this case, this is the cutter and these are the cutting teeth which will cut the desired teeth on this gear blank. Okay, so just observe closely that this cutter will reciprocate and this will rotate throughout its the periphery. This cutter is reciprocating and this gear blank is rotating and the desired teeth has been cut, has been formed on the gear blank. Same procedure can be utilized to generate the internal gears as well, which has teeth, and this is the internal structure where the desired teeth is to be cutted by the cutter. So here remains same, this will reciprocate and rotate in order to cut the desired teeth throughout the whole periphery of the workpiece material. Okay. So these are the external gears on the same. Okay. So in the case of gear hobbing process, this is the hob and these are the cutting teeth on the hob surface, where the desired teeth to be cut. So this is rotating and this workpiece is also rotating desired teeth on the workpiece. Okay, so these cutting teeth are cutting the teeth on the blank. Okay, so today we will discuss the second technique of the gear formation, which is the gear forming processes. So in case of gear forming processes, the important process is the milling, rather we can say it to be as form milling. So in this case, in this process, the teeth on the gear blank are machined individually by a form milling cutter whose cutting edges have the shape of the spaces between the teeth on the gear. So if this is the workpiece material and these are the teeth to be cut, so the gap between the teeth is exactly same as the teeth of the cutter. So this cutter rotates and cuts the gap between the teeth with the help of the machining processes, with the help of the milling process, that will generate the desired teeth on the gear blank. So this is the second type of milling process where this type of cutter is used, which will generate exactly the same type of gap between the teeth. So in this process the shape of the cutter determines the geometry of the gear teeth. The disadvantage of form milling is that the production rates are slow because each tooth space is created one at a time and the gear blank must be indexed between each pass to establish the correct size of the gear tooth, which also takes the time. So this is the main advantage, that at a time only one teeth is being generated, so this consumes a lot of time. Next, for the cutting of the next teeth, we need to index the workpiece exactly to cut the teeth at the exact location. The advantage of form milling over The other gear hobbing, as we have already discussed, is that the milling cutter is much less expensive, and the slow production rates and relatively low cost tooling makes foam milling appropriate for low production quantities. So we can better understand it with the help of a video. So this is the main cutter which will cut the gap between the two teeth on this workpiece surface. So here is cutting and removing the material from the workpiece surface. Okay, so this is the foam milling process. And apart from the milling process, we can also use the shaping machine, the planing machine, or the slotter machine in order to generate the gears. So shaping, planing, and slotting operations can also be used to generate the gears, and generally spur gears. So this is a typical view of this shaping operation in order to generate the gear. So this is the cutting tool and this is the workpiece material. As we all know that in case of shaping, the tool reciprocates and the workpiece remains fixed. So when this cutting tool reciprocates for number of cycles, it creates a groove. It means that the gap between the two teeth, and after the generation of one gap, this workpiece is indexed, is rotated in order to generate the second teeth. In the same way, planing machine and slotter machines can also be used to generate the gears. Okay. Next, we can also generate the gears with the help of rolling process, where the rolls imparts very high accuracy and surface integrity of the teeth, which are formed by material flow, unlike the machining processes. Okay, here the workpiece material is compressed, is applied force with the help of these two grooved rolling wheels, which generates the desired amount of gap between the teeth, and hence a gear is formed. And apart from this rolling, we can also adopt for some powder metallurgy techniques for the generation of gears also. Generally, small size, high quality external or internal spur, bevel or spiral gears are also produced by using this technique. Large size gears are rolled after briquetting and sintering for more strength and life. And the powder metallurgically produced gear hardly require any other further finishing work. We can also use some technique known as wire idiom, where a wire is used to cut the desired shape of the gear required. We can also generate the we can also produce the gears with the help of casting as well. Okay, so next we have the gear finishing processes. The first one is the gear shaving. So gear shaving involves the use of a gear shaped cutter that is meshed and rotated with the gear. So cutting action results from reciprocation of the cutter during rotation. Each tooth of the gear shaped cutter has multiple cutting edges along its width, producing very small chips and removing very little metal from the surface of each gear tooth. Gear shaping is probably the most important and common industrial process for finishing the gears. It is often applied to a gear prior to heat treatment and then followed by grinding or lapping after the heat treatment process. And after the shaving process, we have the gear burnishing process. So gear burnishing is a plastic deformation process in which one or more hardened gear shaped dies are rolled in contact with the gear, and pressure is applied by the dies to effect cold working of the gear teeth. Thus the teeth are strengthened through strain hardening and surface finishes is improved. With this process, both internal and external gears are possible to burnish. Okay. Next we have the gear lapping. So gear lapping is used to finish hardened gears by correcting small errors in spacing, profile, helix angle and eccentricity. So if there is any error in the spacing, the profile angles and the eccentricity, that is removed with the help of lapping process, which we have already discussed previously. The operation is performed with all forms of gears running together with mating gears and cast iron tooth laps under a flow of fine oil mixed with an abrasive compound. So gears are rotated and in between them some lapping material, which we also known as the compound, is used to perform the lapping operation. So this is all about the unit 4, which includes the grinding